The purpose of this channel is to enlighten Messianic believers everywhere, and to expose the weak and inept scholarship of anti-missionary organizations such as Jews for Judaism and Outreach Judaism. My name is Drew, sometimes Drew the Jew, and I'm a believer in our great God and Savior, Jesus, the Messiah. I am an Evangelical Baptist by faith, and a member of the Society of Christian Philosophers and the Evangelical Philosophical Society. I have been interested in apologetics most of my life, arguing extensively with the atheists in my extended family. When I began studying Judaism to see what I'd been missing, I studied Judaism in all of its various forms, from modern Orthodoxy to Haredi and the Hasidim, to conservative, reform, Reconstructionist, Karaite, and yes, even Messianic Judaism, in all of its various forms. I even lived for a year as an ultra-Orthodox Jew in one of those frum communities. So one day, as I was browsing the web during the work, of course, I mean, when else would you be doing it, I stumbled across a site that is pretty simple to remember. I started reading their objections to Christianity, and, well, hey, they were different. At least they weren't the same objections that the atheists always made. I mean, it's interesting, they're giving biblical arguments against us. So, this is interesting, as I began downloading and listening to hours and hours of anti-missionary lectures. These are Jewish rabbis who keep their people away from Christianity. These arguments fascinated me, and as I started looking for good apologetics to counter these counter-missionaries, I was somewhat disappointed at how little information there was out there. There was Jews for Jesus, of course, and Christian Think Tank, and they gave some arguments. I also spotted the Bible Messiah website by Phil Karian, and probably the most fascinating of them all, Dr. Michael Brown's site. He's the most scholarly, I think, of those who answer Jewish objections. He even goes through rabbinic literature to, like the Talmud, to counter the anti-missionary arguments. That's pretty impressive. He's worth checking out. I think the arguments from these sites were actually pretty good. However, they lacked a certain punch to them. Like when you see Michael Brown in debate, he's all nice, and he doesn't give the hard-hitting attacks that you see Tony Blair giving his opponents. For example, in questions to the Prime Minister, often you see him just raking his opponents over the coals. And I want to do that to the anti-missionaries in debate one day. And there are some apologists who are able to do that. William Lane Craig, my own mentor, comes to mind. So does Gary Habermas, Michael Kona, and James White, but since the four of them don't deal with Jewish objections, that burden will have to fall on me. I intend to show you that while God has not abandoned the Jewish people, who are his people forever, Jews who reject Jesus are in rebellion to him and are blaspheming their own creator. I intend to show you that the biblical Judaism of Moses, King David, and Elijah is in no way the Talmudic Judaism of Maimonides, Rashi, and the Kleoker. I am not denying that the practitioners of Talmudic Judaism are fully and legitimately Jews. Certainly, they are. Nor am I denying that Israel has every right to exist. Of course it does. That is not the issue. I am arguing that the religion practiced by these rabbis is not the true Judaism, but is a counterfeit Judaism. I intend to show you the Bible and rabbinic tradition are irreconcilably contradictory. Unless you just assert that rabbinic tradition is the authoritative interpretation of the Bible, end of story, and then you just have succeeded in arguing in a giant circle. I intend to show you that even in 2,000 years of near total apostasy, there has always been a righteous remnant of Jewish believers in Jesus, despite the extreme risk they took by holding to such a belief. And finally, I intend to show that if you approach this situation with an open mind, and let the historical evidence speak for itself, you will find there is far more evidence that the historical Jesus of Nazareth both claimed he was God and was raised from the dead than there is that a historical Moses ever existed. So if you believe the former on historical grounds, then kol vachomer, you'd better believe the latter. Shalom aleichem.